Welcome, folks, to my recently rediscovered 18-year-old video of a tank holiday in Russia. It is the place to go if you like military hardware, and they proudly boast of being the only country in the world that puts current frontline equipment into the museums. Well, I'm just glad it happens. Let's go. Let's kick off with the Central Armed Forces Museum in the great city of Moscow. But my mission is to show you the outdoor exhibits. Oh yes, you did read that right. It is American. Sadly, a lot of my footage went missing. That's one of the things you won't be seeing in close-up. From the very start of the German invasion of the USSR, these two tanks used to make a point of running over and crushing German anti-tank guns that were foolishly used against them. But at the start of the war, most of the Soviet tank park was the BT series, and the mighty T-26. Oh my god, some T-26 porn, based on one of the greatest, most influential tanks ever, the British Vickers 6-ton light tank.
Focus.
And a rousing Bolshoya spasiba to Svetlana, the brain surgeon.
Yes, it's filming now. Oh,
sorry. It's filming.
And if you're up for some delphine porn, I'm here to purvey it. Built as a trainer by Czechoslovakia, it was then used by the short-lived state of Chechnya as a ground attack aircraft in multiple civil wars.
SS-20 transportable nuclear missile. T-10 Stalin heavy.
But I'm afraid I've accidentally doubled it. It was about 11 inches. Which really should be pretty easy for me to estimate. I'll stop now.
Justin, why it doesn't color?
Because I bought cheap. That's all. If I spend a lot of money, it comes out colour. MiG-25 Foxbat. Oh, wow. Sukhoi 27 Flagon. Sukhoi 15 Flagon. Sukhoi 24 flanker. Barely visible. A mighty KV-2. Yes.
Heartbreakingly, the legendary Kubinka Tank Museum was closed! I've lived a good life. Dmitry Donskoy, the victor of the Battle of Kulikovopolye. Moscow was alive with commemorations of that battle on the nice round number anniversary of 625, of course. when you hear people say that the Russians don't appreciate Lend-Lease aid during World War II and that it profoundly embarrasses them, what you're hearing is morons who don't have a clue what they're talking about. The Russians revere Lend-Lease aid and do not take kindly to anyone trying to downplay its role in victory. Note the high proportion of Allied Lend-Lease aid vehicles that were thought worthy of reposing at the entrance to this great facility. Not long after my visit, they actually built a museum of Lend-Lease aid. Now, let's go to one of the lesser-known but underrated attractions of St. Petersburg, the Artillery Museum, which was closed, but Artillery Street is worth anyone's time. You can sit in one of these things, 203mm tracked howitzer. What a beast. That's like encountering a gorilla in the bush in the dark, isn't it? The public roadway in Artillery Street is strewn with the most awe-inspiring artillery weapons imaginable. And the altogether more elegant cannons from the black powder era, sometimes on fanciful carriages, admittedly, but look at the quality, the fleur-de-lis on the barrel. How about, yeah, the serpentine effect? How about cohorn-style mortars, exactly the thing that used to explode on impact, unlike all the cannonballs in movies about Napoleonic or Great Treason of 1775 wars. Those things actually did explode on impact. It's a nice enough street, too, and you look across at the oldest building in St. Petersburg, the Peter and Paul Fortress. If you're anything like me, you're a sucker for a good Russian crow. The things aren't even black, for Christ's sake. They're mostly grey. And they make a fitting backdrop to the setting sun as we look across at the Peter and Paul Fortress down the barrel of a cannon. Again, the heartbreaking admission that I lost the film and can only show you still photos. You can get your fix of T-72 exposure like that, or there's some great aircraft, another Sukhoi 15 Flagon over there. The grounds were highly atmospheric, especially in autumn colours, but I've lost the row of Panzer IV tanks destroyed, I've lost the Japanese tanks, I've lost the Stalin II appearing to burst out of the trees only to be actually standing still, but at least I've got the armoured train that fought in three wars, I get to have the mighty ISU-152, whoa, look at the thickness of that, and I get to have the rare T-44, yeah, the thing that they tried to succeed the T-34 with. I can at least show you the imposing Ilyushin 4 bomber. This thing carried out morale-boosting raids on Berlin at the beginning of the war when the Soviet Union was being completely bulldozed. Then there's the legendary Hind ground attack helicopter. We have plenty of artillery, but hey, who's up for some more T-26 porn? Yeah, the twin turret T-26. Laugh that off. And I got to see the cadets on parade. We come now to the medieval Donskoy Monastery, which was built in 1591 in the time of Boris Godunov of opera fame. I'm not sure if this normally happens, but they had a bunch of armoured fighting vehicles in it. Holy tanks, Batman! It's the Orthodox Church Regiment of Tanks! in World War II again, and rightly so, because the Dmitry Donskoy Battle of Kulikova celebrations prevailing in Moscow at the time are very relevant here. But someone just had to water down the concept, degrade it by painting up weapon systems built decades after World War II, like the BMP infantry assault vehicle, as if they were in that Orthodox Church regiment in the 1940s. I don't appreciate that. You've cheapened it. You've ruined it. What should have been a showstopper of an exhibit instead reeked of stolen valour. Yeah, stolen valour and tacky fraud. Otherwise, the Donskoy Monastery was a wondrous experience. Before I farewell you folks, let's just drop in on the Armed Forces Museum in Seoul, Korea. I haven't got the B-52 and the Phantom on film, but this crappy Japanese artillery piece and the lovely, brave Japanese lady who latched onto me and I was travelling with.
It's Japanese.
Thank you, good people, for watching my slightly dubious project right through to the end. You do me much honour. Good night from the Jaguar Knight.